Okay, are we live? Am I live? I know last time I did this, I managed to stay silent for a full half hour.
You're sounding good, buddy.
Okay, great. Let me bump you up, because I think you're about as loud as my, my music. In fact, I'll probably just, like, tone down the music just a hair. From minus 16 to, like, minus 22. Very audible. Fantastic. Okay. So, guys, sorry for the delay. It's about half hour after I wanted this to happen. As always, Emerald Jr. throws in an extra variable into the mix that I cannot anticipate all the time. So, hey, welcome to the stream, Moose Chat, Moose Track. Wait, I've seen your name before. How come this is the first time you're... Okay, you know what? Never mind. It's cool. It is that time of year again, every September, for the past, I want to say, 5 years now. That doesn't sound right. 4 years or 5 years? Which year is this? Yeah, I think this is the fifth year. Okay. This is the fifth year, I believe, I'm holding this. Yeah, I think 2019 was the first one that I did on the revival. We don't really count 2019, though. That one was a little bit of a mess, but we figured out the format, and for the past 4 or 5 years or so, we'll call it five, I've been running this annual Sega Saturn anniversary game competition. Originally supposed to be timed for the window between the Japanese release and the North American release of the Sega Saturn, at least for its birthdays. You can take through that what it is, but basically during the last third of the year or so, I invite everyone to submit all of their Saturn homebrew, Saturn patches, and Saturn-related tools to the competition, where the panel of judges will evaluate, based off of their own personal biases and merits and rubrics, which ones are their favorites, which ones are their least favorites, and all those scores are combined to determine what the best original game of that year is, the best hacks patch, or translation, and the best Saturn utility of that year is. Now, this year is kind of an evolution of last year. Last year, the big thing was we had not quite as many, just a handful fewer entries as the previous year, but we had a massive prize pool ahead of time, very early on. The competition just kind of launched, so I'm anticipating the prize pool to grow a little bit more than it did last year. But this year, the prize pool has expanded in a different way, and I'll get into that in a little bit. Now, the rules, as ever, is that whatever you work on this year is basically the majority of what you're presenting should be based off of work from this year. So if you're submitting an original game, it should be something that you're making where the majority of the effort, like you're making an engine. I mean, we've had kind of edge cases where there's like ports, but you're remaking an engine or you're utilizing outside materials or outside binaries in order to generate new content that's distinct from just applying a patch file to an existing Saturn title. An original game entry just falls under all those categories of you represent the majority of the work done here. And it to be posted in the 29th anniversary competition, you need to demonstrate whatever work has been done in this year. So if you have a multi-year effort, like Ponut's Slide Hop, you need to provide to the judges a description of what's been done in this year. Same thing with hacks, patches, and translations. There are many translations that take multiple years to achieve and complete, so it would be nice to get a kind of like a rubric of here's where most of the improvements have been made this year. And additionally, for hacks, patches, and translations, please provide me a save file so that when I showcase all of your guys' work, I'm not showcasing the first 5 minutes of the game like I manage to do every year. I cannot promise to have enough time to make progress to the point that you probably want to show off. So if you have a save file that I can insert via one of Slinga's tools or even Aerosoft's QR scanner from last year's utilities entry, that would be very grateful. Utilities is a kind of like a catch-all miscellaneous category. If you're making a tool that helps with Saturn homebrew, if you're making a tool that helps with Saturn, like a lot of the times there's save files, a tool that helps you hack around in Saturn games or Saturn hardware, that's where that kind of stuff goes. It's all software, but it's all stuff that's meant to be utilized as part of the Saturn hardware, either to make games or to interact with the games or interact with the hardware. We've had a lot of different entries that fall into this category. We've had the Netlink Tunnel and its updates. We've had multiple save game file extractors, which have been enormously useful for the community. We've had different homebrew tools, the Film Muxer, which helps you regenerate video files with new audio or different audio to help with the production of Saturn fan translations. Without the need for encoding, yeah. Because unless you're an encoding wizard like Trekkies Unite 118, it's usually kind of a headache to try to figure out how to get that stuff to work properly. I never managed to get it to work as well as I wanted to, or even barely at all. But that's a factor of me not putting in enough time to get that done. So the timeline for the competition, I'm trying to be very generous with the dates here. I want to give everyone a full weekend into the new year in order to finish up. So think in your head that you should be done with the major work of whatever you want to do by New Year. But the competition entry deadline is 12 a.m. UTC on January 8th. If you're on American East Coast, that's 7 p.m. on January 7th. So by then, you should have some form of ISO or BenQ pair uploaded to the contest thread, which is linked right here. So I'm going to click this link. Takes me to the Sega Saturn 29th Anniversary Game Competition Contest thread. You will have to make a... go away. You will have to make an account to get onto the Sega Extreme in order to DM me for your prize money and also to just submit the entry. So go ahead and get that done ahead of time. From there, the judges will have about a month or so, four weekends at least. Hey, Pudgy Bunny, welcome to the stream. I guess Danthrax kind of dragged you in here or something like that. So 4 weekends from that that submission deadline on February 9th, the judges will be expected to be done with their scoring. As always, judges will need to be able to complete an entire category's worth of scoring in order for the scores to be valid for that category. And I'll explain the scoring in just a second. And then immediately afterward, I will, on a live stream, showcase all of the games, all of the tools, all of the patches, etc., etc., in reverse order of their ranking to reveal who the winners are and the cash prizes, among with other prizes that they won. Now, this is scored, as always, in kind of like a reverse numerical order. So a judge will rank his or her favorite games, 1 through N. So the favorite game gets a score of 1. The worst game gets a score of however many games are in that category. So in the case of all 9 judges submitting the scores and they all pick the same favorite game as a top score, oftentimes a competition between XL2 and Seven Shades or someone, essentially if all 9 judges submit scores and they all pick the same favorite one, then a perfect score would be 9, as in 1 9 times. And that would be the lowest possible score, and that is the top rank. And the bottom rank would be a much, much higher number, something like a triple digit number. So the lower your score on the rankings, the better you're doing. So I want to kind of highlight the sponsors this year, because this is like the highlight of this year's competition. Of Fenrir fame has agreed to donate a Fenrir ODE to the top prize winner. I found my first, oh my goodness. My first misspelling. I'll fix that in post. Top prize winner of the original game category will be receiving a Fenrir ODE. And Krista Lee from Sound Retro Co. Will be installing that Fenrir pro bono. And on top of that, will be recapping a Saturn and installing an FRAM mod, which is a way for the internal save memory to not require a battery in order to maintain your save files. A very useful modification to have on a Saturn. Of course, you will need to be able to provide a Saturn to claim this prize. Otherwise, maybe you could utilize your prize money and we could try to locate a Saturn for you. Okay, Pona, I do remember that year, but that was kind of like a dark horse kind of thing. No pun intended. I'm not counting on being super competitive this year just because of my changes in life plans and some of the projects I'm working on right now. But next year, I plan to come out swinging with Sceneryu, and I plan to actually make a strong competitive push for first. This year, I'm assuming that the competition will lead more between you and Seven Shades and whatever other surprise candidate like Bridget Bishop with Fran Matsuzaka did last year, something like that. But, you know, JPEG Plane is not completely out of the competition, I think. I think Xenos might be still working on some stuff for that. But I'm thinking first prize is not going to me this year. And I wouldn't want to anyway, because this is the first time that we're having this kind of prize. And I think it would be a really weird look if I managed to win it. Every time I update this freaking website, I see 10 million errors I didn't see while typing this thing. As always, MillenniumShane90 from That's It Guys has his 3D printing service. All cash prize winners will be entitled to a 3D print. This time, we're kind of restricting it strictly to this list. So pick something from this list to please just, you know, to narrow down the time it takes to choose something and also have things printed so we can ship it out as soon as possible. We're still shipping out prizes from last year. That's still happening. Knight of Dragon, I apologize. I totally forgot to put that on my edit. I will add you to the sponsor list as an additional prize recipient. Knight of Dragon is working on a serial cable in order to have an additional online connection for the Sega Saturn as an alternative to the Netlink adapter, the modem. So the way it works is that the Netlink tunnel should be able to support serial output, aka the Tizen cable out, if as the main utilization of that port was before. And so he's actually utilized his prize money from last year to generate a whole bunch of cables to actually utilize that, and all games, all online homebrew games should be able to utilize the Netlink tunnel, and I believe the patch that's been provided last year should be compatible with virtually every online game so far, so that we can just effectively have everyone go through the serial port. So Knight will require people to cover shipping and handling, and I guess taxes for the shipping and handling for that, so that would come out of your prize money. So if you are a ranking a prize recipient, a cash prize recipient, and you would like a serial cable, let me know ahead of time before I pay out your cash prize. So once again, top prize winner OG category Fenrir plus FRAM mod plus recap for a Sega Saturn provided by top prize winner. All cash prize winners get a 3D print from this list from That's It Guys. And Knight of Dragon, provided that you give up some shipping and handling, will provide you a serial cable helping you to get online. The cash prizes so far, this bold warning, just, you know, keep in mind, this is kind of what I said before, is you really need to get back to me within a timely manner in order to get your prizes. All prizes, you know, you need your cash prize or physical prizes. Get to me by March 15th if you're a winner. DM me on the forums. Tell me how you want to be paid. Tell me what shipping information I need in order to get you any physical prizes you want to claim. So the prize pool rolled over a little bit from last year. We had VBT and Slinga both give up their cash prizes into the prize pool. I haven't been able to ship anything out yet because of how long it took for everyone to choose their 3D prints. So that shipping estimate is back in the prize pool. Joe of Joe Engine fame has provided $40 minus PayPal's modest fee into the prize pool, and as always, I'm helping to fund this competition out of my own pocket. So, minus the estimated shipping costs, the shipping the Saturn back and forth is going to be a little bit pricier than we previously anticipated. So far, the total prize pool is a little over $200, split up between 14 prizes. So, the prize money is broken out like this. OG, as always, gets the primary weight. 15% for first, followed by 10 for second, 8 for third, and then 7, 6, 5 for 4, 5, 6. Hacks, Patches, and Translations top prize is 12, followed by 7% for second place, 5% for third place, and then 4% and 3% for fourth and fifth place. Top prize for utilities is 10%. Followed by 5% for second place, 3%, or basically the remainder of the cash pool or the prize pool for third place. As more people donate to the prize pool via this PayPal donation link, please, everyone, go to emeraldnova.com. I'll even directly link the competition page. It's also linked on the Sega Extreme forums. The more you donate, the bigger the prize pool gets, and the more incentive we have for more entries for this year's competition. Otherwise, kind of the same as it was last year. And now, let me go ahead and announce the judges for this year. So, RevQuixo and Saturn Memories have dropped out, so I have sought out a new replacements in order to keep our 9 Saturn judges, the Supreme Court of Saturn. So our first new judge is Krista Lee. She is owner and operator of Sound Retro Co. And she is the one installing and recapping the Fenrir and the Saturn that, for the top prize winner. David Jimenez, Corbidou, is back as always. Jason Steele, Film Cow, once again back. And a really fun thing that happens with Film Cow's judging is that every year I've seen him go on Video Game Valley and play a lot of the entries, and for some of the visual novels, he's actually live voice acted, which is actually, it's very entertaining. Live voice acted a lot of the visual novels that get submitted. Genovi Reviews is back. Johannes Fetz is back. Yes, of course, thank you all the judges for serving the community like this, because it is a non-trivial amount of effort considering how many entries we get. Pandemonium Reviews, Saturn Dave, and Traino Co., the Shiro Bros, are back. And taking up the additional empty seat is the Segaholic, another Saturn-focused YouTuber who's also a co-founder and co-host of Sega Guys, a podcast, I believe, available on all the podcast places, iTunes and whatnot. So that is the judges' lineup. The scoring this year is going to be super easy because of all the PHP I just did last minute. So as soon as the entries are in, the judges start scoring up, you'll see it populated on this website and automatically tabulated with hopefully very little room for error. Okay. Embroidered Saturn hats and badges. So Moostrack, if you can DM me on Discord later on, I need to get with Knight of Dragon to figure out the particulars of how this is, of how his prize is going to work, and add him to the sponsor list. But if you're interested in providing Saturn hats, I can give you an estimate for what I think the shipping would be. So just DM me in Discord later on, and then we can arrange that. And then next time I have a stream, I can kind of update the competition situation on the competition website. But everyone, for updates to the competition, please go back to emeraldnova.com. If you go to the homepage, it is linked directly there, except the typing is wrong. It's not the 28th. It takes you to the... Oh, it is the 28th. Oh, did I forget to update? Here, give me a second. Come on. Oh, boy.
Wait, is that the old page? Because everything's saying 2022.
Yeah, it is the old page. For some reason, my FTP is... Okay, there we go. Let's try this. There we go. Now the link is working. Sorry about that, guys. Again, a lot of this was done last minute. Yeah, even when we announced VDev, yeah. I've been doing PHP for a few hours now. A lot of it was probably stuff I didn't need to do, because what I was doing... is I was going back to the, I had not updated the 28th anniversary competition yet, but now all the PHP is working to automatically tabulate scores, as I described. So these scores are now accurate, and now I have the infrastructure to do it for this year as well. Yeah, it definitely wouldn't be a stream without errors, and obviously, I don't really have time to edit video as well as I can. I have been trying to do just the marginal amounts of editing on some previous streams to try and smooth over some errors and stuff like that, but I honestly don't have time for it, and I have too much stuff in terms of homebrew I want to do to focus on being a YouTuber or good Twitch streamer. no robot voice. That's an internet thing, though. That happens. So that is the announcements. If anyone in chat has any questions, why does it say Game Boy Advance? Seriously? I'm going to have to edit this video. Oh boy. There we go. Yeah. But thank you, everyone, for coming onto the stream. It was just a quick announcement. I didn't have any real plans for tonight's stream. I was hoping to just be in and out very quickly just to do the announcement. Thanks for the follow, Moose Track. And again, once again, if you're interested in sponsoring the competition, please DM me in Discord. Or on the forums, even the Sega Extreme forums. Yeah, everyone's hard work is... Let's just go back real quick to the 28th competition. Just to see, like, all the entries that we've had. So since Sensigolo, he does the visual novels. Damage X usually has some pretty nice polish. Him and Herbalsoft tend to do a good job in doing nice, small, self-contained, complete experiences. XL2, as always, is the Saturn wizard in terms of 3D experiences. I usually try to punch in with something, even though it's usually pretty cobbled together last minute. Fran Matsuzaka surprised us with Bridget Britiship. You just experience magic. I'm not going to describe anything about magic. You just experience it. Voxel was doing work with Sonic Extreme. I believe he's retired now, like XL2. VBT, come back again with Wolf 3D. VBT's our port master, so he does a lot of emulation and port stuff on the Sega Saturn. So if you go in previous competitions, you see him work on some different stuff. Herbalsoft gave us a Chip 8 emulator. I didn't even know what Chip 8 was before that, but that's like the first time I've experienced it. Raimi has a long-term project with Sky Blaster. And you can click through on these links and see all the previous year's work. Disasteroids by Slinga. So Slinga is our multiplayer task force. So every time he submits a project, it's like a 12-player project. So you can actually get two multi-taps and max out the connections on it and try to play one of his games. And I've managed to do that because I had to go and source 12 different controllers just so I could see how well it worked out. Knight of Dragon, I mean, Knight, you can speak for yourself if you want, but like you work on so much different crap, I have no idea when you find time to do it.
Just gets done.
Yeah. So Danthrex, like, honestly, like, this competition, I don't think it was ever meant to really be this big. It just kind of organically evolved. So, like, when I started it, it was never supposed to be this much work to run it. And now that I'm doing it, like, I'm kind of, like, committed to doing it. So, yes, I'm not going to pretend to be, like, humble or whatever. I'll accept the gratitude for, like, running the competition, which is a non-trivial amount of work now. It didn't used to be. I wasn't planning on putting in this much work for this kind of thing. It was just supposed to be like a revival of the earlier Rock and Bee competition days. But at this point, I think we've completely eclipsed it with all the entries and the cash prizes and the amount of notoriety. I try to make do my best to bring in judges that have street cred for Saturn, that know what they're talking about, know what the Saturn's about, and have a connection to the Saturn, but also can help like proselytize for Saturn homebrew and promote, because I want people other than ourselves to play our games. And I think the judges panel that has been evolving over the last few years has helped to do that. Okay, I was listening to all the games. Like you guys, like the hacks and patches kind of speak for themselves, because they're usually the most popular portion of the competition, and the utilities are generally stuff that we as developers and sometimes users tend to appreciate more than what other people do. I'm going to try and wrap up the stream now, but I just want to point out that yes, the community does a lot of hard work behind the scenes, pretty much always unpaid, to try and not only revive portions of the library that maybe never made it to the English-speaking world, but also make some new content that, you know, at least might be entertaining for a few minutes. I hope that every Christmas, someone in the Saturn community finds time to play Galaxmas, even though it's kind of like barely an okay game. So, if no one has any questions about this year's competition, about the rules, the prizes, I will be updating this page with some spell check and also Knight's additional sponsorship. But otherwise, I want to thank everyone for coming on stream. I don't have any other plans for tonight, so I'm just going to wrap up and close out. But everyone in the Saturn community, everyone who does homebrew, get to work, get to submitting. You know, the more people submit this year, probably the bigger the prize pool is going to be next year.